to try to talk really loudly so that you can all hear me. And my light has changed a little bit, so I think we can see. I think we're going to be okay. We're going with it. So I'm glad you're here to foam roll today. This is almost, I haven't had a massage in a really long time. This is almost as good. Not really, but only because at the end of, we're going to do a total body foam roll today. And it's kind of the same feeling at the end of this that you get when you're after your massage, and I like that feeling. So this is a good option. Also, I want you guys to keep in mind, your clients can benefit from this also. So yes, us as wellness professionals, massage therapists, any manual therapist that uses our body to help others. Hi, I saw something pop up. Oh, good. Hi, Ariel. I'm not going to be able to say hi to everybody because I'm so far from my iPad right now. But hi. Thanks for being here. What was I saying? So remember that you can assign these to your clients because they really need the same stuff that we're needing right now. If a lot of people are stuck at home or they're not able to do the exercise routine that maybe they're used to, or they're just not knowing what to do. So many people have a foam roll these days, I feel like, because there's so many different kinds you can get. There's different densities, there's different colors of this. There are short ones, there's long ones like this. There's ones with little knobbies on them. There's ones that vibrate that are great for a little massage. So whatever you have, bring it with you to class today. Also, a tennis ball is great. In our massage clinic, we always gave these away to clients. It's inexpensive. They like to walk out the door with something, and you're going to teach them after their session maybe one self-care foam rolling. It's kind of myofascial release. They can do a little self-massage for them with their tennis ball before they leave. And you hand up the ball. They know what to do. You check in with them next time they come back and see how it's helped them. So if this is all you have today, borrow it from the dog, whatever you need to do, we can do some foam rolling with this too. I also have a lacrosse ball here. It's a little more dense. The tennis ball gives a little more. And I have a yoga block I'm gonna do one or two things with, but mainly everything today is with our foam roller. All right, so one little bit of, if anything hurts while you're doing these today, stop, don't do that one. Also, I'm gonna try to give you a level one and a level two as far as if it's something that you need or you feel that your body can go a little bit deeper today with some of this rolling, then there's a couple of options and ways that we can use gravity and our body weight on the roller to intensify it a little bit, I guess. As well as this lacrosse ball is pretty intense, so maybe you want to try some things with that in the future. All right, so you guys can say hi as you hop on, and let's just hop in, and we're going to start at the bottom of our feet. So those clients with plantar fasciitis, us, you know, anybody, because feet carry us all day long, thousands of miles, right, throughout our life, and we don't pay a whole lot of attention to the bottom of our feet. Or any portion of our feet for that matter. So I'm gonna do this kneeling, which isn't quite as much pressure as I would like to get on the bottom of my foot, but as soon as I stand up, I kind of go out of camera. So we're gonna do this, you get the idea. All right, so I'm gonna pick a foot, we're gonna roll with the foam roller across the bottom. Feet is one that I'll kind of go quick, a little quick back and forth motion. This is the only muscle group I do this with. I feel like it generates a little bit of more blood flow down here. I like to just do a quick little wake up, and then we can slow it down. Hi, Gail. And then we can slow it down a little bit just to get anything. You can put more pressure on the bottom of your foot. So if you guys are able to stand from home, you know that that is a lot more pressure, more gravity, a little more intense if you need it than kneeling like I'm doing here. So as we progress, we're going to push and hold, and then we're going to do the other foot. So for everything today, I want you to remember, keep breathing, and you You know, some people think you would need a whole 30 minutes to go through a whole foam rolling session, but you can really get from your head to toe and maybe be done in 10 to 12 minutes. And that's because we're going to be able to move through some, depending if you were doing this at home, you can move through the pieces that you don't feel need as much attention that day and focus on the pieces that do. So I'm not having a lot of pain in the bottom of my feet right now, but if you were, you'd spend a little bit longer here. Okay, let's move on to calves. All right, so come with me, seated position, foam rolls out. We're gonna try to roll all the way Achilles tendon up to before the back of your knee. We know that's an endangerment site massage. We also don't wanna put a lot of pressure at the back of the knee. So for this one, you can do two legs at once. And I've had to lift myself off to get enough leverage here. You could do flat palms and lift. Probably a level one, and maybe what most people are going to want to do for this muscle group, it's a little bit easier on your body too, is just push your foam roll off to the side under one single calf. I'm going to lift up on my other leg, lift my hips off the ground, and now I've got a whole foot in my hands supporting my body weight, and you can decide how much of your body weight you need to roll for that muscle group today, okay? So there's that one. I'm gonna go over to my other calf. You wanna be even here. So you guys roll with me there. Ask questions, make sure you can hear me. Turn up your volume. I know I feel like I'm yelling, but I've gotta make sure you guys can hear me. Okay, on this one, I also think it's important to hit lateral gastroc as well as medial gastroc. So what I'm gonna do here is take my whole leg, externally rotate it so that we've got the outside of your gastroc against the foam roll and roll that way. We know that the soleus muscle is working, getting some work here too. So now I've internally rotated my whole leg, so I want the medial aspect of my gastroc here. Okay, so get your lateral and medial on your other leg while I look at this really quick. Hi, thank you, Andrea. Sounds good. Okay. All right, so we've got gastroc. I do have one thing for those of you who would like a little bit more intense. I don't know, I feel like runners, soccer players, who else would need calves? Those people who love the stair machine at the gym, I don't know. You went on a hike. Hikers probably may need a little bit deeper through their calves. So I like a yoga block, and then use your tennis ball, or this is a lacrosse ball. You're gonna put your calf right on top of that. Okay, it is more intense if you get your hips up off the ground, okay? More pressure's on that, or you can sit here and do it. But then I like the idea, I like the idea of adding like a pin and stretch here. So as we're, get to the point that you feel like with your ball, and you can do this on your foam roll too, if you don't have a ball handy. So you get to the spot that feels like it needs it the most, which is those tender spots. And then as you flex your ankle, go into a point, and then I move slightly. And it's not even a whole inch of a movement probably, it's just a very subtle forward or back, left or right, to get the whole spot that's tender. And then keep with your point and flex of that ankle moving, okay? Okay, so that's a little bit deeper for the soleus and gastroc muscle. So let's go on to the tibialis. Obviously we don't want to roll on our shin here, but we are going to roll, let me try to come up here a little bit. Okay, so this is one where I've taken and bent my knee over the top of the foam roll to be on my tibialis. Now, if this doesn't feel good, because this is a pretty big bend of this knee joint here and the angle and all that, don't do this one if this doesn't feel that good. Okay, so we can roll tibialis here. And we can switch. So it's just little movements. So this is matching my tight gastroc today. I feel like my tibialis anterior also is needing a little bit of attention here. So this on my own full rolling session at home, I just hang out longer here. And then maybe you can move faster through some other muscle groups that don't need it as much. And then you can just pause. So I kind of like to think of this, and maybe you can explain this to your clients as well. You know, when they're receiving a massage, and maybe some of you use a pain scale between 1 and 10, 1 being they really don't feel any pain while you're working with a certain technique on their muscle, and 10 maybe being the worst pain they've ever experienced. So the 1 to 10, I kind of like with your foam rolling, this is going to be a little uncomfortable, so I would say roll yourself anywhere from a number 4 to a 7. So this shouldn't be hurting so bad that you need to get off your roll. Like when we get to the IT band, a lot of people, it's super painful, and I don't want you rolling it if it's at a 9 or a 10 or even an 8. So we're going to do it a little differently, okay? So just remember, uncomfortable is good, it's fine. Just don't have up to really high on your pain scale. Okay, let's go to the always needed hip flexor. So your iliopsoas here, we're going to have to push the, we're going to do one at a time. And this again, lots of people, so cyclists really get tight IT bands. Maybe any of your clients who are sitting at a desk job a long time, a road trip, a plane flight, things like that are really going to get people tight through these hip flexors. So if you take your foam roll off to the side, we're just going to do my left hip flexor right now, and I'm coming down right so the edge of your foam roll is in the crease of the hip, kind of that tendony area. And we're just taking and doing a roll forward and back. And you may need to adjust the angle of it, just get it to where it feels right for you. Okay, I'm gonna go to my other one. Get your opposite knee that you're not using, up that leg up out of the way. We're gonna come down right on top of this roll. I'm trying to see if you can see these. It's easier to see, not really. Okay, I'm playing with, like there's a bunch of light on this mat. I wanted you to see better. Okay, so there's psoas. Let's move to your quadriceps. We can do two quads at once, and then I'll show you a little bit of what feels good for the quads. So come down, foam roll under your quadriceps. I like to come out on my elbows. And you're just going to roll back and forth. You can kind of walk your elbows back and forth. And then if anything feels extra tender, we can stop and hold. I like to do a little bit of a flexion of the knee, extension of the knee, flex and extend. And go ahead and do one. Oh, video is getting messed up. Okay, go ahead and do one quad at a time if the two isn't feeling like your body wants to do two at a time today. And also remember the one, single one, you're going to be able to get some of your body weight off the one leg by using the other one that's off. So it could look like a roll this way too. Okay, I'm hoping our audio and our video is all fine, you guys. Okay, this actually, single leg's working better for me today. I'm getting a whole lot more, yeah, that kind of hurts. A lot more option here for attention to the quads. Okay, we're gonna keep moving on. So we've got piriformis we can do next. And I like this idea, really, it'll kind of hit all the glute muscles, which are super important. And if we come and just take a seat on your roll, I kind of like this one to cross your foot in front. So use this, as well as a hand down. And you can lift with this foot and this hand, you can lift up off if the piriformis, so we want to be at deep external rotator, those piriformis in the hip. Okay. Hi guys, who are hopping on now? Thank you. Okay, the other thing piriformis is we could add a little bit of a piriformis stretch to this, and then we're still sitting and rolling back and forth across some of those glute muscles. Okay, so that's kind of working better for me too, is by crossing that leg over. Okay, so kind of level one with this one would be just get on the foam roll. Sit on it and roll. Then level two, I'd cross the leg over, so the foot sitting on the opposite knee, and roll that way. It's a little more intense, and you can kind of wiggle and slightly move and adjust the muscle and how it's hitting onto the foam roll to see what your body needs the most. Okay, from here, we're doing IT bands. Everybody hates IT bands because they kind of hurt. But we're gonna roll them. We're gonna roll the TFL muscle up at the top attachment. So let's just do it. All right, so your IT band lays completely lateral here along the outside of your leg. So just get a foot down. Remember, get some weight. You don't have to have your entire body weight and gravity and everything on this IT band. Lift some off with this foot and this hand. All right, so TFL's up high, right? Okay, that doesn't hurt as bad. As you're rolling down, remember, stay within your pain scale. This shouldn't hurt a ton. Get some weight off the roller with your other foot if this is hurting more than 7 on your pain scale. All right. Keep breathing. So I've moved down halfway down my leg. Okay, I'm going to move it down even further. I'm working down towards the outside of my knee a little bit here. Back up. Okay. Yeah, that's another squat that doesn't feel great on me today. So let's do the other side. We got to be even. So I'm lifting my body weight off as I take the roller down a little bit to where I want it to connect here. Lift my body weight off, move the foam roll, because these are only rolling just a little bit forward back. you guys got IT band done, TFL. Okay, let's move a little bit on to thoracic spine. We're gonna do something kind of nice just to do a basic roll all the way up your spine. So come to seated in front of your roller. We're gonna lean back against it. Okay, you're gonna raise your hips up off the mat or off the floor. And you're gonna roll. You can support your head and neck a little bit with your arms like this. I'm not rolling all the way down to my low back, so just kind of stay, I don't know, C7-ish, and then try to get down to T12. And then this one gets overlooked a lot, so let's do some lats. And again, this one doesn't always feel great, but you're going to come down on your side. So we're kind of hitting armpit area right below, but we know your serratus anterior sits here, but we want to try to roll all these lats. And this one is really good for some clients too, if you want to assign this as homework to somebody. You know those ones on the table that are needing either the scapula's down and back, retraction, they're too rounded forward. Anything that you try to do, subscapular work, I've found it's really beneficial to have their lats a little more opened up. And you can get it during the session, but you guys know any time that they can go home and do some of this in between when they see you, the better. And the more progress you can make for them. Okay, so there's lats that side. You guys switch. Get your other lat so you match. So really I would say the general rule, you would only need to foam roll 2 minutes tops for an area, and we do need to get both left and right, so you know that takes enough explaining and talking, so it would take a little bit longer, but certainly if you got through all of this it would be much less time for you normally. Okay, here's another great one for manual therapists, or we're gonna go to forearms. Anyone that has a job maybe that's typing repetitive motions. I've had some musicians who need forearm work. So I'm thinking of people that you could send home homework with for this particular one. Repetitive, like a checker that stands a lot at a grocery store or something that has a repetitive motion there. So we're gonna do it with the foam roll. You can also do it with the tennis ball. But as we come down, so completely supinate, palm to the ceiling. Okay, so forearm down. Now I'm gonna apply some pressure with my other hand or my other arm, okay, to kind of sandwich the arm that's being worked on here between the foam roll and your other arm or tool. We could even sit with a tennis ball and press down. Okay, so I again like to create a pin and stretch here because I think that it's great, and as massage therapists we are so flexor oriented that we all need to be more opened through here, through the palm of the hand, the fingers. So I think that this pin and stretch targets our specific needs really well. So if you flex, bring the fingertips towards the ceiling, press down and extend. Okay, we're gonna roll a little bit now, so I'm in a different spot. flex fingertips, flex the wrist, fingertips towards the ceiling, press down with my top arm, and extend. Okay, I'm gonna roll to a new spot. Fingertips towards the ceiling, press down, and extend that wrist. Okay, so it really probably only takes, let's say, 4 pin and stretches on the whole way down your forearm. So I'm gonna do my other one really quick. You could do this even probably between 2 balls. I would be probably up a little higher. But anything that's more specific, if you need more specific than a broad base of the foam roll, you know, these tennis balls and other tools can get more specific for your forearms. Okay. I like to include levator scapula. Levator doesn't work great because the foam roll isn't specific enough, but if you do have a tennis ball or if you want to try this later, we're going to do it really quick here. So levator scapula, we're going to place the ball behind. Okay, just bend your knees, lay down. Once it's there, right at the top of that superior angle of your scapula and you are on your ball, take your arm back, kind of like a backstroke in swimming. And that intensifies it more like a level 2 on that one. If all you want to do is lay on it, perfect. There's level 1. Take your ball to the other side. Arm up. And I just go through about 3 of those range of motions. Okay. So let's do a little bit for your neck. I really do like the idea of a couple of tennis balls, like put them in the end of a sock and tie it so they stay together. And then those 2 balls would sit really nicely right under the occipital bone. So we've got the occiput here and we can do a little bit of movement to open up those suboccipital muscles and the neck. With your foam roll though, let's make it look like this. Just get it back under your neck head. And then you're looking left, right, and just do a roll for those muscles at the top of the neck. It doesn't get it as specific, but if you did have a couple balls, you can place them under the back of the neck for that. Okay, a little more specific. It feels maybe a little bit more like some trigger point work or something under there, which is nice. Okay, one more I want to do today, and then I think we're about done with the foam roll, is we're going to do the pectoralis, just because I feel like no matter if you're a manual therapist, massage therapist, anybody who sits at a computer desk, those people who, we're all forward rounded through our chests and shoulders quite a bit, so let's add a pec here. Again, pec would be great if you want to grab your tennis ball and lay on it, you know, a little bit more specific, right? But we've got our foam roll. Again, we're going to push it off to the side so that we can get just the end of the foam roller in this crease, kind of above your armpit where it's kind of tendony in there. We want to get these little attachments. So I'm going to have you lay on your stomach, come down. And you can see I've got my arm out. Let me move my head out on my foam roll out here, okay? So we've got just the core. on a roll. Okay, now you're gonna have to play with moving your body, maybe moving the angle of the whole roller to where you can move slightly back and forth and just have this end of the roller massaging those attachment points. Let me see if I can show you through here. Hi, Rebecca. Okay. So here's a little bit better light coming in. Okay, so we're going to go on your stomach, end of the roller, arm out, and then move. And then don't be afraid to just go with the how it feels like. Just play with it. There's no really right or wrong. You can't hurt yourself. But if you're not feeling any results, then I want you to move your foam roller or move your body slightly or twist the angle of this. Okay, to have maybe a different angle or vector into the muscles that we're doing. Okay, so there's pectoralis. All right, you guys, I think we've wrapped up everything that I wanted to do with it today. We did pecs. Remember that you can assign it to clients. If you would like to email me, I can give you this worksheet printout handout, basically, that you can give clients. You could even break it up and say if you only wanted to give them, let's say, the psoas or the hip flexor foam roll for homework. I mean, you can do what you want with the paper. So we're the Fit MT, and you guys be fit, be strong. You guys be the fit massage therapist. So my email to get that, if you would like it, is thefitmt@gmail.com. And I'll just send you that workshop. You can use the handout. And just remember, you're going to breathe through it. That's a key. Doesn't need to be more than 2 minutes on any certain muscle group. And just have fun doing it. You should feel pretty good now at the end. So thanks for watching today. I'm Angela Robertson.